this love of mine.
I'm infatuated with her. Utterly infatuated. And it wasn't at a healthy level. Far from it. I would think of her every moment she was away. I would sometimes sit on my couch and just stare at my phone, waiting for her to text. I'd tell myself, don't contact her, don't. It'll come off as too strong. But then I'd still find myself clicking her name on my contact list before my inner voice would continue. You don't want her to know how desperately smitten you are with her. It's unattractive. It'll scare her off. No, you must wait for her to call you this time. But it was excruciating and exhausting, almost unbearable. I once heard the ancient Greeks believed that falling madly and irrationally in love with someone was a curse that you would wish upon your enemies. I can never understand what that meant. After all, isn't falling in love, head over heels, the ultimate goal nowadays? But now that's happened to me, I have to say, the ancient Greeks were right. This is a curse. I was barely in control of myself. The two of us were very active together, but still in the quote-unquote dating phase. We were at that make-it-or-break-it era of a blossoming relationship, where we'd either have the talk and formally be in a relationship, or we'd start to drift apart slowly, the latter of which I don't think I'd be able to cope with. Honestly, I wouldn't be able to. Most everything about her captivated me. Her smell, her smile, her eyes, all of it. Yeah, I know. It probably makes you sick hearing about it. I feel the same way. I was never the hopeless romantic type. But now, I can't stop thinking about her. I think about us doing that long, 3-hour hike up to that magnificent view from one of our first dates, to that first kiss, as we overlook the lights of the city. But this time, I'd get down on one knee, bring out the ring, and, well, you know what happened next. All right, fine, I'll stop. Yes, this is a girl I'd only been casually dating for a couple months. I shouldn't be thinking about proposing yet.
The sun and the moon, the stars that shine, what's to become of it, this love of mine, this love of mine.
So I swear to God, after that, my boss literally almost gave me a goddamn heart attack.
Actually?
I swear to God, I've needed an aspirin every day since.
Oh my God.
Hey, I was wondering if I could talk to you about something.
Yeah, what's up?
Well, you know, we've been dating for like a couple months at this point now, and I think things are going great and everything. But you know, you never really seem to stay over. You know, we've been here since, like, 4 a.m. some nights, and, like, is there something wrong with me?
No,
is it, like...
no. Listen, I knew this was gonna come up eventually, but recently, I've been talking in my sleep.
Seriously? That's it?
No, Steven, you don't understand. It's not like I say gibberish or just some random stuff like that. No. I say horrible, nasty things.
Hey, look, I don't care, all right? Spend the night. We'll be fine. Trust me.
I guess you're probably right.
I always am.
Steven, are you coming to bed now?
Yeah, in a second.
Something about this night seemed off to me. It should have been like any other night, but I felt all the abnormalities start to crack open like an egg. The problem was, this whole thing was abnormal from the start.
Hey, so I was thinking tomorrow that we could try that new diner down by Route 80. I was talking to one of my friends about it. He said it was pretty good, so I figured, hey, good breakfast, you know?
Sounds good. Hey, if anything happens tonight, just ignore it. And don't respond. I'll get all disoriented and scared, you know?
Yeah.
If you have to sleep on the couch, I won't mind.
Hey, look, I don't care. It's not a big deal, honestly. I'll be with you the entire night. Well, that's all. Good night.
We both seemingly fell asleep without incident. I don't know how many hours passed, but I had the sensation I was being watched. Then I remembered she was with me. Nothing could have prepared me for that. Her eyes, her smell, her stare, it all terrified me. I don't know how I can bring this up tomorrow morning.
You can hear me, Steven. Why don't you come back to the bedroom?
I didn't say anything. I was told not to. If I heard her walking towards the bedroom door, I swear, I would have sprinted out of the house. She told me not to respond.
Sorry if this spoils your plan. The two of you were supposed to walk the trail again. You would be so tired when you reach the top. You'd look over the city, then you'd get down on one knee and bring out the ring.
The problem wasn't just sleep talking. It was something much more. something supernatural. I never told anyone about my proposal fantasy. There was no way she could have known about it. I have a couple more hours left until morning. The scariest thing about this situation is the maybes. Maybe my captivation and obsession with her wasn't normal. I said before, I was losing control of myself. This was more than a typical love story. No, the infatuation was slowly starting to take control of me. I know, I should leave. I should open my front door, get in my car, and drive away. But I can't leave. I can't leave her. I've already lost control. I'm infatuated with her. Utterly infatuated.
Over yonder, the valleys where we lay, lush grass never grew.